Today's subject is reverse mortgages. Well, you know, as people get older, oftentimes they build up a lot of equity in their home, and they essentially can become house rich and cash poor. Folks who are older oftentimes do not want to leave their home, but they'd like to find a way to get equity out of their home to pay some bills and expenses. So here comes the reverse mortgage. Now, reverse mortgages are available to people, and unlike conventional mortgages, you don't have to repay them back. In fact, you can get income from a reverse mortgage, and interest and principal accumulates backwards, unlike a regular mortgage. Now, it ultimately gets to be paid back. Oftentimes, when a person dies, the estate has a chance to sell the home, pay back the mortgage, and anything left over is inherited by the estate. Now, there are different types of reverse mortgages. I thought I'd focus on just one here, and that is the federally insured reverse mortgage. It is called a home equity conversion mortgage, and it is put together by the Federal Housing Administration and the HUD, or Housing and Urban Development. Now, to be eligible for a reverse mortgage, the people on the property's deed have to be 62 years of age or older, and at least one homeowner must have this property as their principal residence. Now, if you are 62 or older and co-own the property with a spouse that is less than 62, you may still be eligible for a reverse mortgage, provided the spouse is not the borrower under the reverse mortgage. Now, the homeowners must receive reverse mortgage counseling from an agency that is approved by HUD before getting a reverse mortgage. This is to make sure that the borrower understands all of the particulars about a reverse mortgage. Now, there are limits on the amount you can take out of principal and borrow. They are affected by age, home value, FHA home loan limits, and interest rates. Now, there are also several ways to receive the proceeds from a reverse mortgage. You can receive a lump sum. Another way is called tenure. Now, that's equal monthly payments for the rest of your life. You can also do a term loan, reverse loan, that pays you payments for a specific period of time. And you can get a line of credit where you can use the money as you see fit over time, or any of the above. Now, reverse mortgages are expenses. There are application fees, there are appraisal fees, there are minimal credit check fees, there are organizational fees, there are mortgage insurance premiums fees, and there are annual fees, just to name a few. So you're not going to want to do this lightly. You're going to want to make sure that you understand all of the fees, all of the particulars when it comes to getting a reverse mortgage. It's certainly not for everyone, but in certain circumstances, it does work very well.